Welcome to Seeking Prosperity. My name is Richard Grant. With this outlook, we would like to share our thoughts on the weeks ahead and what will be driving the markets. We will provide regular updates if and when we see things changing. On a macro level, we have new lockdowns and mandates in Europe. In the US, we have more people having to leave the labor force. Small businesses are crushed and inflation is getting out of control. Then we have exponentially growing debt, a real estate and financial markets bubble, and deadlocked rates. Looming blackouts, supply chain collapse, threats around cybersecurity, and a future where everybody is supposed to live with 50% less of everything. Civil unrest is about to explode. I can't really recall any point in time where so many bad things happened all at once. But as the markets are fueled by liquidity creation, they will most likely continue to go up. Just look at Venezuela, total destruction while markets continue to go up. But in the short run, we would expect a correction before the market goes higher. With this, I would like to move over again to Natalie Kornikova with a market deep dive. Hi, Natalie. Thanks for joining.
Thanks, Richard. It's great to be on the show again. So let's start with the S&P 500. Looking at the chart, there have been three attempts to break through 4,700, and it is shaping out a flat type of structure on the top. The Dow has already corrected below 36,000. Same with the Russell 2000. Both have reached a support zone, though. The Nasdaq has shown enthusiasm but has intraday lost half of its gains, so even here a correction is likely. I don't expect a large move down yet, just a normal correction of a couple of hundred S&P points, and then the continuation of the upwards trend, which is a usual buy-the-dip opportunity. Because more problems mean more stimulus and better environment for big tech while everything else suffers. Gold has broken out of its downtrend. I would expect it to consolidate around 1,825 before continuing its move upwards unless they hammer it down again. Crude oil has corrected down quite a bit, and there is room to around 70 USD. I would expect it to consolidate around these levels before going for climate agenda goals of $100 or much higher than this. Bitcoin has had a little correction and it seems it is losing steam. It made a higher high but could not get to 70,000. But it also made a lower low, so it will be consolidating for a bit. At some stage, there will be a big crash, but I think the time is not yet here. There are other goals leadership is facilitating at the moment, so I would suspect the markets to hold up. But difficult to say, one might also think that more chaos would push things forward even more. With that, I see a couple of potential black swan events. 1. Acceleration of the European crisis spreading, new lockdowns and mandates. 2. U.S. default on debt as a result of the debt ceiling issue, which is still unresolved. 3. Crypto bubble collapse. 4. Cybersecurity-related issues. Or something else, big enough to be utilized as the triggering event for the next stage of all of this, but this is just speculation. With that, handing back to you, have a great time despite all the troubling stuff around us.
Thank you very much, Natalie. Greatly appreciate your input. The world is a big, orchestrated stage, so much is clear. What are you guys thinking about all of this? Where will we be heading? Please let us know in the comments below. Hope this content is helpful to you. If so, please share, subscribe, and like, so that YouTube shares this content with a wider audience. That would be awesome. Thank you very much for watching, and all the very best to you.